Good morning all. Today I'm going to give a lecture on Kaizen. So we have seen about continuous process improvement, Jiron's triology cycle, plan, do, check, act cycle in our previous presentation. In this presentation, I'm going to explain about Kaizen. Kaizen is a Japanese term which says that K means continuous and Zen means improvement. Together, it says the meaning of continuous improvement. So, we shall see the definition. The Kaizen philosophy assumes that our way of life, be it our working life or social life or our home life, that is personal life, deserves to be continuously improved. So, whatever may be our life, either working life or personal life or socially what we move, we need some improvements day by day. Kaizen is the technique adopted for improvising everything. So we shall see what the Kaizen focuses about. The first is value added and non-value added work activities. Whenever we work under any institution or organization, we need to categorize the works as value added and non-value added activities so that we can neglect which is like non-value added. The second one is muda. Muda means it is like waste, which refers to seven classes of waste. We'll see the seven categories. That is overprotection. Overproduction means producing more products. Delay because of not reaching in the proper time. Transportation. Some problem may occur due to transport, poor transport. Processing, maybe the process may be very poor. Inventory. Inventory means this is the organic waste. Wasted motion. So, and defective parts. So, these are the different kinds of waste you can find whenever you deliver a product. That product may be having so many, like muda means this is a different types of waste happened by the company. So we need to observe such waste types. The next point is principles of motion study and the use of cell technology. Principles of motion study means the best or effective way of doing a particular work. So we need to study that how it becomes smarter, how we can complete the task. And the next one is principle of material handling and use of one piece flow. Use of one piece flow means you can customize the product one by one. So the pieces, like the materials or the product, will be produced one by one. So when producing one by one, easily you can customize the products. The next one is documentation of standard operating procedures. So whatever you do, how you will document the procedures which you are doing. And the next one is 5 years for workplace organization. We already know that 5 years means sort, set in order, shine, standardize and sustain. So these are called as 5 years. This 5 years have to maintain in the workplace. And the next one is visual management. This is the easy method of monitoring the mistakes. Just-in-time principles means on-time delivery, on-time production. And the next one is Pokayuk. Pokayuk means it's like mistake proofing or error prevention activity. And finally, team dynamics. Together, these things together forms or focuses on improvising the Kaizen. So if we do this value, like if we segregate the value added, non-value added activities, and also we are knowing about the different ways happening in our company, and how the smart ways to do the work, and how to use like one by one, how to customize and save it for future reference and to avoid the poor quality, and documenting the proper operation procedures, and adopting that 5 years procedures like sort, set in order, shine, standardize, sustain. If we follow these things correctly, and visual management means finding the errors which is not known, and that errors can be easily viewed and rectified. And if we deliver the products on time and everything goes in time, And like if we find the mistakes in the Poka-Yoke method, and finally if our team works very dynamically, our Kaizen will be improved. So now we shall see the re-engineering concept. Re-engineering is a fundamental rethinking and radical redesign of business process to achieve dramatic improvements in critical contemporary measures of performance such as cost, quality, service and speed. Re-engineering means it's simply like rethinking or redesigning the business procedures. So we will be already we will be following a conventional method to achieve certain goals, but if you keep on going in one particular direction, you cannot achieve your goals, and even you cannot find any improvements. So whatever you do, you need to think, you need to redesign in the way which you are already following, because the world is changing day to day, and the expectation of the customers also changes from every period. So for that, we need to take particular measures or performance, like how to reduce the cost and how to improve the quality, service, speed. We need to think about that. This particular process is called as re-engineering. So these are the explanations on Kaizen and re-engineering topic. We shall see the other improvement techniques in my next video. Thank you all.